course. So I need not go to the introduction, tell anything about the introduction of telemedicine. Then I will start with, many of my slides are already covered in his presentation. There are actually different types of telemedicine services. Mainly there are the different types are primary care physician consulting with a specialist. This is a commonly used thing. Then paramedical staff consulting with doctors, and also patients consulting with doctors. Patients consult from the hospital with the help of a telemedicine operator or a junior doctor from there, or patients use a mobile device and they can consult with the doctor from their home. In addition to that, there are other services like tele-rehabilitation services. Palliative care is one of the, telehealth is used for palliative care, especially in Kerala, it is used now. Then another area this framework is used is tele-education and training for patients and health professionals. When we did our on-call project for Assisi Trivandrum, we gave these tele-education sessions to nurses in Srinagar, in Jammu and Kashmir, there at the hospitals there. So even in 2003, we did the tele-education services in this using this PSAT network. Then digital transmission of medical images, there is teleradiology, telepathology, is another type of telemedicine service that we are using. Of course, the latest advanced thing is robotic surgery. That is, telesurgery is done using robots. That is also another type of service. Like that, there are different types of service. Then this is also Dr. Mishra has mentioned, different types of telemedicine technology. That is, store and forward is one type. Then real-time interaction, that is another type. Then remote patient monitoring, that is another type. Then mobile health. These are the various types of technologies. I'll just briefly cover about these. In the store and forward technology, actually the clinical details of a patient, including the medical images, diagnosis, presenting complaints, all these investigation reports, everything will be captured as and when the patient is present. But it is compiled and it is made, and a patient health record is created, and that is sent to the specialist doctor in an offline mode. So at the specialist doctor, whenever it is convenient for him, he will go through all these details and he gives his comment. He can view the images of the patients also. He will give the comment. He will provide the diagnosis. He will provide all the treatment. Also, he will prescribe. And this will be saved as part of the electronic health record. And this will be available for the patient, for the doctor, the patient, and this information will be the suggestion or this diagnosis or this treatment details will be provided to the patient by the telemedicine operator or the doctor at the patient. Actually, this is a cost-effective solution, and the time also of, we need not have to fix an appointment with the specialist doctor. So the time also can be saved. The commonly used and most popular one is the real-time interactive technology, where there is a face-to-face discussion between the patient and the doctor, between the two ends, the patient and the doctor end, using a video conferencing equipment, a face-to-face interaction is going on. The specialist is at the referral site. Most probably it will be at the tertiary care hospital, and these interactive services can provide immediate advice is given to the patient. That is the advantage of that. This real-time interactive methodology is used for all types of all specialties of medicine. It is used. This, a patient's medical history and all the consultation details, presenting symptoms, diagnosis, everything will be captured. And during the next visit, the history of the patient will be available for the doctor. If the teleconsultation is continuity of a care is given for the teleconsultation. Then the third one is remote patient monitoring technology, remote patient monitoring. Using this, medical professionals can monitor the health and the vital signs of the patient continuously. This is required in the case of chronic diseases, such as heart disease, diabetic mellitus, etc. And this is also very useful and valuable because it is giving, it is found very, very much effective continuous frequent monitoring can be provided for the patient, and the patient is getting greater satisfaction. So this is the next method. And yeah, these three are the three different types of telemedicine that we used. So run forward, real time, and remote patient monitoring. And now my topic of my presentation is telemedicine technology, network, and systems. Actually, telemedicine is a group of technologies within the healthcare IT. It uses the digital information, that is, the entire clinical information is digitized, and it is shared across different stakeholders, or patients and doctors, using the telecommunication technology. That is the thing. Digitization of the clinical information and transferring it across the communication network. The major components are the software and hardware. It is actually an interface between the hardware. There is a hardware part, there is a software part, and a network part, and there are systems. It is an interface between all these things. So coming to the telemedicine hardware that we commonly, if a doctor in a clinic wants to set up a telemedicine system, the minimal thing required, the basic things required is either a computer or a laptop or a tablet PC or something. Then a video conferencing equipment. Now these laptops and mobile devices are all having audio video facility, but it is better to have a video conferencing equipment, because nowadays these video conferencing equipments are available in a lesser cost. So we can focus the patient, we can zoom, pan, tilt, zoom facilities available for the video conferencing equipment. So instead of using the web camera of a laptop, it is better to go for a video conferencing equipment. Then audio systems, external microphones and speaker, we can set up printer, scanner. With this minimum hardware, we can start a telemedicine. For advanced system, to capture the parameters from the patient, we can use digital stethoscope. It can be transmitted from the patient into the doctor and in a live mode. Then digital ECG, digital microscope, then X-ray film scanner or digital X-ray machine. Digital camera, high definition camera is used, dermatoscope is used. Then bi-directional screen sharing facility is there. For example, if two doctors are discussing some MRI image or something, so same image can be viewed can be shared between the two screens at two remote ends. And some annotation made by one doctor. This is the volume of the tumor in this shown. Doctor can mark the tumor volume and the size. He can write something also. This is the length. This is the breadth, like that. So that will be viewed at the remote other end instantly. Then remote patient monitoring devices is the next thing. These are the commonly used and actually required hardware items for an advanced telemedicine setup. Remote patient monitoring devices that we use are, this is actually mentioned in Dr. Mr.'s presentation. We use digital ECG devices, digital stethoscope, digital body scale, urology analyzer, BP monitor, pulse oximeter, smart watches, fitness band, etc. Then Internet of Medical Things, that is it's a collection of medical devices and applications that connected to healthcare systems through online computer network. IOMT is a new terminology. But a few examples of such things are remote temperature monitoring for vaccines, medical data transferring tools, then air quality sensors, drug effectiveness and tracking, vital sign data capturing, sleep monitor, remote data, such a long list is there. Then the hardware things we have covered. And coming to the telemedicine network, the communication network commonly used for telemedicine in India are internet broadband connection. Now we have a pretty good connection using fiber optic cable, or leasing connections are there, radio frequency is there, and this VESA, very small aperture terminal, that is satellite connection provided by ASRO, that is not much used now. During the initial time of telemedicine process, we were depending on the VESA connectivity. Even though they are providing only 384 kbps for connecting the regional cancer center Trivandrum with its 7 peripheral centers, we were having very good performance that day. Then ISDN connection, then Wi-Fi, WiMAX, then mobile communication technology of at least 4G is required. In rural areas, we can use the plain ports, plain or telephone system, if there is not much image transfer is not there, for transferring of clinical information that can be used. So recommended bandwidth, everybody is asking that how much bandwidth is required. 1.5 Mbps is a minimum requirement, but depending on our requirement, if it is in a hospital where multiple doctors are using, more bandwidth, a Wi-Fi system with more bandwidth is required. And if you are sharing images, medical images frequently, higher bandwidth is required. So then coming, telemedicine software is one another important aspect of a successful telemedicine system. Actually, the telemedicine is centered around the telemedicine software. Major features of the telemedicine software are the electronic health record of patients. It is patient health record. There we are creating, when a new patient is coming, we are creating a patient details by capturing the patient demographic information. Then unique health ID is provided for the patient. So that we can have one ID is provided for the ID is UHID, unique health ID is given for the patient. With that, we can link all the clinical information of subsequent visits and we can provide the continuity of care for the patient. So the entire, if it is a continuous treatment, if it is a diabetic patient, he'll be coming. We have to provide them this frequent teleconsultation. So in that case, that entire previous history is recorded. So the details are clinical details are linked using the UHID, unique health ID. Then video conferencing. In telemedicine software itself will provide a video conferencing system. If an additional costly, it is not that costly now, video conferencing equipment is not used. In many of our, there is one software that we developed in CDAC. In that also, and Mercury telemedicine software developed by CDAC Pune, they're all telemedicine software, telemedicine, that module. So that is also part of the telemedicine software. Video conferencing software is also a module of the telemedicine system. Then data transfer. For transferring the patient electronic health record from one place to another, there is a particular transmission protocol used. That is another part of the software. Then imaging module. So the medical images is shared across different locations. So the DICOM standard capability is required when we are transferring this image. Then only the image can be used in the using a DICOM viewer, and annotations can be made. So the imaging module that is developed as part of the telemedicine software should have the should follow the DICOM standard. Then mobile telemedicine app, the other things I told till now is a web-based telemedicine application. Then this mobile telemedicine app application then can be downloaded by the patients and can be kept in their mobile phone, and they can fix appointment with their doctor. There is facility for fixing appointment. I have another slide about that mobile telemedicine app. Tell about meeting. Then major functionalities of a telemedicine software are patient registration. That is, new patient is registered by capturing his demographic details, which I told now. Then unique health ID is issued. Then the patient can book appointment with any of the doctor or with any of the hospital. He can select the hospital. He can select the department in the hospital. He can select the particular unit that works, or he can select the doctor who is working in the particular unit. That much selection can be done. Then audio and video calls supports. Then a personal health information is captured. When the doctor-patient consultation starts, the doctor will collect the clinical presenting complaints, then examination details, then provisional diagnosis, medicines, e-prescription, medicines prescribed, investigation details, diagnostic investigation ordered, everything can be entered. So the software should have the facility for entering the prescription, medicines prescribed, investigation ordered, everything. All these submodules should be there. Also, the patient's vital signs can be captured. This is provision for calculating and track the caloric intake. Remainders also can be scheduled for taking a particular medicine. Then record physical activity such as daily step count, then messaging, e-prescription. The patient, after the consultation is over, the patient can download the prescription in his mobile and get it from the medical stores. Then also the patient, when they start the consultation, he can upload some investigation, previous investigation reports or previous case sheets, everything can be uploaded. All these facilities are part of the telemedicine software. Also in some, many of the system, telemedicine softwares available in the market, there is payment also. So online payment also can be done. That facility also shall be provided part of the software. This is a sample telemedicine software. So you can see that one particular patient is selected and his any of the thing can be selected from the left side, and this ECG of the patient is viewed here. Then an image is, X-ray image is viewed here. Then annotation is made on the image. On the right side, there is a consultation between a patient and doctor is happening. Test chat is, the facility is there. Okay, this is just a sample. Then coming to the different telemedicine systems, instead of explaining the theory part of it, I think it is better to explain some live projects, few live projects that we have done. This is a system architecture at a remote hospital. You get an idea of what all things are required in a remote. This is the patient end, actually. At the patient end or the peripheral hospital, see the connectivity. Is VSAT or the broadband or least an ISN connectivity is coming, then routers and switches are required for connecting to the computer, or if multiple doctors are using it through the switch, it can be connected to multiple doctors in a computer. Then an X-ray film viewer, X-ray view box is there. If an X-ray view box is given, we have to provide a digital camera to take the image of the X-ray, and it can be uploaded and appended with the electronic health record of the patient. Then digital ECG machine printer is there, and then UPS also is provided, LCD TV, video conferencing system. This is the setup in a remote hospital. Then system architecture is at a specialty hospital. All those medical equipments are not required. Other things are only that is required. Then actually, Dr. Mishra told about the connected health. That what he meant is, it is an enhanced grid-based approach to telemedicine. That is, a multiple hospitals, for example, in Kerala, all the government hospitals are now in a single grid. All are connected together. It's a single grid. So a patient can consult with any doctor in any of the government hospitals, with any doctor in a government hospital. That is the live system that is proven in the state of Kerala. There are 1,300 hospitals in Kerala in a single grid. So it can provide a single point of communication for any specialist in a group of hospitals. So the same thing is now coming in a national level called Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission. NDHM was renamed as Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission recently by our Honorable Prime Minister. So one person, one electronic health record across India is now going to come. That we have done in Kerala some 2-3 years back. One person, one electronic health record for a resident of Kerala. So this is the eHealth Kerala. I'll explain some details about that. As part of eHealth Kerala, originally there was no telemedicine facility, but due to the COVID pandemic, we had to do the telemedicine also. We had to introduce telemedicine also as part of eHealth Kerala. And then the eHealth Kerala project is, in brief, I'll tell about that. It is an IT-enabled integrated framework connecting 1,300 hospitals in public sector. The very basic concept is one person, one electronic health record. Lifelong, and the entire treatment from birth to death will be available as a single electronic health record. It can be viewable for the citizen through a citizen portal, and for the doctors in any hospital. The basic vision is an integrated healthcare cloud is set up, which can hold the complete healthcare data of all the citizens in the state. So eHealth Cloud of Kerala is set up in the Kerala State Data Center in Trivandrum. This hospital management system, the application server and database server are centrally in the state data center. and the hospital management system manages the entire workflow in a hospital. In addition to the hospital management system, the public health data is also digitized and fully, it is fully integrated with the hospital management system. It is an Aadhaar-based unique health ID. We have to authenticate a person when he comes to the hospital as a patient. So using an Aadhaar, a permanent unique health ID is given. If a patient is not coming with Aadhaar, a temporary UHID is given. So thus we are creating a unique electronic health record for a patient. So along with that, we introduced the telemedicine facility during the COVID pandemic period. That is, we developed an application called ME Health. So using that, the patients can download the application in the Android phone, and they can register. If they are not having a UHID, they can generate an UHID using their Aadhaar card, and patients can book appointment for teleconsultation with any doctor in any of the government hospitals in Kerala. Then the patient will be getting the date, time, and token number will be given to the patient. Token number means a time slot will be given. So at the time slot, the patient has to log into the application and wait for the consultation. So then a video consultation with the doctor will happen. And after the consultation, a prescription will be issued and that will be downloaded by the patient. During the consultation, actually there is another facility also. When a patient is admitted and is discharged from the hospital, the doctor knows the review consultation can be offline or online. So if an offline review consultation is sufficient, in our software, the doctor will mark this review consultation is through teleconsultation, and the doctor can provide the date, time, and token number for the particular patient for his review teleconsultation. So that facility also is provided. Also in the OP consultation module, we have provided a facility normally the doctor will be coming, prescribing medicines, and we will ask the doctor to come after 1 month. So this can be a teleconsultation if it is such a case. So in the application, the doctor will mark, next is a review consultation, is a teleconsultation, date, time, and token number will be given. So the crowd in the hospital is reduced much. The centralized EHR, telemedicine consultation details are also appended with the electronic health record of the patient. That is the main advantage here. This is a photograph of teleconsultation happening in Medical College Trivandrum. So the patient's clinical information is seen on the screen. That is a doctor's OP consultation module. Medicine prescription, everything is there, and the patient can be viewed and the consultation is happening. In addition to that, we have provided a public health facility. There are 9,600 field staff in the health department. They are provided tablet PCs for visiting the houses and doing the disease survey. First they are doing demography survey. 80% of Kerala population is captured into our database by scanning the QR code and the Aadhaar card. The details are captured and a member ID is given. And JP, junior public health nurse or junior health inspector, they are visiting the houses once in 2 months. So when they visit the house, in this tablet PC, we can provide the telemedicine application. So when they visit the house, these field workers can provide the facility of a telemedicine consultation for the bedridden patients or palliative care patients. This facility can be provided with the help of the field staff who are visiting the houses. Also, there are sub-centers which are coming under the primary care, primary health centers. So many of the patients are coming to the sub-centers also. They're frequently visiting for getting medicine for the diabetes mellitus centers. So in the sub-centers also, GPs can arrange a teleconsultation for these remote patients. So these are another advantage. There is another new project for providing telemedicine services for the tribals in the Wayanad district. This is a vehicle developed by this is a project based in Trinidad Hospital and Sri Dr. Vandram, but now it is handed over to the health department. So we are integrating this with the eHealth Kerala project. So this is the inside of the vehicle and the components on board in the vehicle. That is desktop computers and video conferencing system, high definition camera and audio system, mobile camera for close examination of patients, then close examination camera with a magnified view, digital ECG machine, digital oscilloscope, patient examination table, scanner printer, etc. And also there is a telemedicine software that generates the EMR. So some health workers are ASHA workers are visiting the houses and motivating these tribal patients to come to the primary health center. So there are two vehicles provided. So from the vehicle, the expert consultation is appointment is taken for expert consultation with the doctors at medical college, Sridhar, etc. And so this is integrated with the e-health software now. Now it has become part of the e-health work. This is a photograph of the teleconsultation happening inside the vehicle. And next, then another project, very successful project of we have developed, implemented the project in RCC Trivandrum and Adyar Cancer Institute, Adyar Chennai. So these are two projects for the cancer care for rural masses we implemented in 2005 and 2010, that period. It was done using this for regional cancer center Trivandrum, it was using the VSAT connectivity. For Adyar Cancer Institute Chennai, it was a it was VSAT connectivity. So in RCC Trivandrum was linked with the five peripheral hospitals across Kerala. In Cancer Institute Adyar Chennai was linked with the seven peripheral hospitals. Two are in Andhra Pradesh, one is Andaman Nicobar Islands, and the other is in Tamil Nadu. So these were two very successful projects. And even now they are using it very effectively. This is the architecture. Coming to the technology part, you'll get an idea about how the left side is a specialty hospital and the right side is a peripheral center. There also this telepathology, teleradiology system is used as part of this project. We have provided at the remote centers, we have provided X-ray film scanner using which if the patient is coming with an X-ray film, it is scanned and the digitized X-ray image is sent to RCC Trivandrum. Then we have provided the digital microscope also. So this is the system, digital microscope. At the patient end, at the peripheral end, you can see the digital microscope, X-ray film scanner, and all. It was a VSA network, and as a backup arrangement, we have provided ISDN also. That was the popular. This was done in 2005 period. But still, it is used very effectively. It's very useful for the cancer follow-up patients. They don't have to travel all the way to Trivandrum for a follow-up consultation. Because for 90% of the cases, the doctor will be telling continue the same treatment, same medicine. This is the telepathology and teleradiology system used there. Then few other mobile telemedicine units that we have developed and successfully implemented are, one is a Sanjeevani mobile tele-oncology unit. This is a very effectively used for around 12 years. Sanjeevani mobile, this is provided for the Malabar Cancer Care Society, Kannur. It is linked, this vehicle is linked with the RCC Trivandrum for teleconsultation. These are the equipments provided inside the vehicle. This is specifically for cancer treatment. Mobile X-ray unit is there. Computerized radiography unit is there. Ultrasound scanner, video colposcope. Even video cryosurgery is done in that vehicle. Then digital microscope, digital ECG, biochemistry analyzer, hematology analyzer, gynecology surgery table, and glucometer. Then that is connectivity. You can see that VSA connectivity is provided on that vehicle. So this is how it is connected through VSA, and also we have provided a WiMAS connection also to the GPS tower. An alternate connection is also provided. Mobile unit is connected to the specialty hospital. The patients in the cancer patients in the northern part of Kerala is very effectively using it. This is an inside view of the Sanjeevani unit. The connectivity that TV, computer. is a the surgery table is also provided inside. There is one surgery room there. This is another teleophthalmology unit. Teleophthalmology unit, two units were provided, one for Regional Institute of Ophthalmology, Trivandrum, and another one, its name is Nayanapatham, given for District Hospital, Palakkad. Both of them are using it very, very effectively, but this is going to the remote parts of the district, in Palakkad district and Trivandrum, and doing diabetic retinopathy evaluation is done. It's inside of that fundus camera is can be seen inside it, inside of the Sunayana vehicle. The Sunayana vehicle consists of, in addition to the other connectivity and things, slit lamp is provided, then fundus camera is provided, refraction unit for vision testing is provided. There we are using, in these two vehicles, we are providing bi-mass connectivity. And if the nearest PSC is having another broadband connectivity, there is facility for connecting from the nearest PSC to the vehicle also. The telemedicine room at the specialty hospital for this at Regional Institute of Ophthalmology, we have provided a computer workstation, high-end video conference system, LCD TV, then LAN facility, because doctors and optometrician, both of them are viewing it. So LAN facility is also there. Then bi-mass connectivity is provided, and as a backup arrangement, Kerala State Wide Area Network is coming to the hospital. So that is also connected to the vehicle. Then a fully furnished telemedicine room is also required at the specialty hospital with proper acoustics and electrical system, proper lighting, etc. is required. Yeah, this much is my presentation.